Hey everyone, it's time. So we're gonna start. If you can please turn on your camera so I can see that you're here. Okay, if you have no ability to use the camera, that's fine. But if you have the possibility, I would highly suggest doing so. So we're gonna start. So hi, my name is Hila and I will be your chair for this round. My preferred pronoun is she. And I will now allow my panel to introduce themselves.
Hi, I'm Caoimhe. My preferred pronouns are she or they, please.
Hi, my name is Smee, no pronoun preference.
Okay, so let's start with teams. So opening government, if you can please tell me the speaking order and your preferred gender pronouns if you wish.
My name is Yerkebulan. My gender is he.
Second speaker is Nurtas, no gender preferences.
Thank you. Opening opposition.
My name is Ainagul, first speaker, and personal pronoun is she.
My name is Tleukhan, and I'm the second speaker, no gender preferences.
Thank you. Closing government.
Hello, am I audible? Hello? Hello?
Yes, you are audible.
My name is Raihan Rahman. Actually, my teammate has not received her link to the Zoom. So she's unable to join for the moment. So can we wait a bit longer, please, ma'am?
Well, there is the link on the announcement page as well. And it's quite easy since this is a streamed room and there aren't multiple. So just tell her to go to the announcement.
Okay, so I'll be telling her.
Can it take more than a minute, I'd say.
Okay, it'll be enough.
Okay, so let's continue with closing opposition.
Nurlan speaking first, Samat speaking second. Hila day, please, for both.
Great. So let's wait just a second and we'll start. Hey, if you can please open your cameras again, if you have the option, it will make it so much more pleasant to all of us. And I saw some of you can use the cameras, so I know you can. So please do, especially when you're speaking, but also when other people are speaking, it's nice to speak to people, not to black squares. Okay, so we're gonna start your team. Your data team member can join soon. Again, the link is at the announcement. So there shouldn't be a problem to join at any point, okay? So I'm very happy to call upon the Prime Minister to open this debate.
Thank you for the speech. We think we understand that the problem of this debate is about truth. So we think each table agrees that truth is absolutely good, absolutely benefit of this debate. So why is so important? Because just in truth case, people can make their own decision. That freedom of choice will be implemented in case of truth informations. So fake news are of freedom of choice. So I think everybody is agree with this claim. So we regret Twitter adding fact check functions because we think this function will hurt to the freedom of speech. Why? Several things. First of all, we think that these high profile tweets, belongs to influencers. For example, it can be presidents or prime ministers or some activists which many people follow, for example Trump or another presidents or another first leaders of the country. And after this fake news function, these influencers can put under pressure these people. For example, Trump. If, for example, Trump write in Twitter something fake, Twitter can show this for the people, and after that, rates of the Trump will go down. So after that, Trump can do two things. First of all, Trump can go away from the Twitter and use another independent medias. For example, he can write his opinion by Fox News or another news channels. And the second thing, he can hurt Twitter or another social network companies that will implement fact check functions because he would not want to be under the pressure. He won't write fake news somewhere. So the two things can hurt to the freedom of speech. In the first thing, we think if this influence go away from the Twitter, we think that people will have no place to can resist against these opinions, because if Trump will not be in Twitter, then another his followers also do not be in Twitter. So in the Twitter, there will not be debates about his post. His post will be just another channels. So in these channels, people cannot see opposite opinions. This can be just one side propaganda. So why it is good if Trump posts fake news in Twitter? Because in Twitter, another people can retweet this tweet and show that it's fake news, and Trump can also retweet his, and they can debate each other, and people can see that one side wrong or another side right, and people can choose and can choose their choice, and people can know about this problem. The second thing, in the case of interfere these social networks. For example, in some countries, presidents can ban these social networks, like Russia or another countries. So people can demonize this social network, in this case Twitter, and more and less people can use Twitter and organize among the political problem, and they cannot solve the political problem without this organization, because Twitter is huge power to organize people to the strikes or to the to debate about political problem, and we think there will be better world without fact check function in Twitter. Thank you.
I would like to thank the Prime Minister and call upon the Leader of the Opposition. Hear, hear.
Let me set the timer. Before I start speech, I will accept POIs in the fifth minute. First of all, a response to the opening government. The speaker said that high authorities like Trump will create new channels or new social media, but we think that it is not probable to happen because it takes a lot of time to social media to get popularity. Twitter, this social media that was founded in the 90s or 2000s, I don't know, but it's one of the oldest, and it gained the world popularity. We do not think that one person who usually lies in social media hold too much power to switch one social media. Coming to our case, we think that let's give characterization of these fake news. Fake news are usually very controversial. They can be conspiracy theories. They can be a wrong interpretation of existing facts. They just cherry picking information or statistic and making into something untrue. And it also appeals to public's fears and etc. But we think that even if it's hard to identify and search for fake news, we think that facts are easily identifiable. And if we have some researches or from specialists, for example, in a coronavirus situation, we have some doctors or people from health organization who can fact check that. And why this fact checking is very important? First of all, it allows us to make informed decisions. For example, if you have whole information in front of you, you can make meaningful decisions. For example, you are more likely to believe that vaccine can help you, or in the case of Brexit, you won't be you won't be coerced into voting for Brexit because some politician lied in Twitter that if we do not do Brexit, there will be a lot of job losses, which is in fact not true. And in the era when we have in status quo, we already have difficulties in plurality of opinions because of echo chamber, where people are constrained with particular bubble. For example, conservative media are conservative people have only conservative news in their feed, and it is hard to get through to other sources of news or listen other opinions. But in the situation where people see that Trump lied in his statement, they can question their opinion of Trump, and they might dig deeper into this, into his claim, and maybe approach news more critically. At least we raise awareness. Does anyone have POI? If no one has, we think that it is important to do fact checking because it's possible some facts can be checked. For example, what effect coronavirus has on organism, or professionals have a common consensus about certain issues such as Brexit, and we shouldn't, and we think that it's unjust to make users to have uninformed decisions in their future. As an impact, we will have people thinking critically about news, authorities thinking, being accurate in using some facts, and there will be less monopoly of some opinions.
I would like to thank the Leader of Opposition and call upon the Deputy Prime Minister.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, one second.